Hey there, it's CaraNightly, and tonight I have my oh-so-lovely kitty cat. His name is Milo, but he is not the star of this video. No. Tonight, he thinks he is. Have the Magic the Gathering Mystery Booster Convention Edition packs. Now these are just 15 card boosters. See if my cat will let me in here. I understand they may be having some of you here that just want to see me open the packs, and I will make sure I leave a timestamp down below. But for those who would like to enjoy the tingles and some sounds first before we dive into opening the packs, just stay tuned. Stay tuned. Okay. So, also pulled this one, Al Amaret's Archive. Look at how pretty it is. So pretty. And then we also got Perforus, God of the Forge. This one is pretty high up on the list, so we were pretty excited to pull this one. And so yeah, and then these packs all come with these really fun test cards, and I think that I will use these in another video, because I think it could be really fun and nice to sketch them out and just sort of read them in detail, over explaining perhaps. So, I think that video's to come, but stay tuned. I'll apart from those, though, these are our most valuable cards, probably about $90. Well, that we have basically earned in value so far. And we're gonna see what other value awaits us in these packages. I really, really, really love these deck boxes. For now, they're just holding these pieces. But the magnetic closures are pretty great. Okay. I don't want to spend too much time just wanting to let you enjoy the sounds with me. Okay, so let's go ahead and see what's inside, I guess. A sorcery, light walker, and chart a course, leapfrog. That sounds fun. Leapfrog is flying as long as you've cast an instant or sorcery spell this turn. Okay, that's pretty cool. Return to centaur. Okay, lethal sting. One is Spark's Bitter, Elemental Shape. Oh, sorry, Spell Shaper, not Shapeshifter. Chartooth Cougar, Cat Beast. Okay, Mountain Cycling, Well Wisher, Creature Elf. Okay, that's probably pretty good. You tap to gain one life for each elf on the battlefield. That's pretty good. It's a pretty good life gain. Yes! I got it. Priest of Didiana. I think I just pulled her in another pack. Okay, cool. So I've just got another one of her. Draconic Disciple. Okay. Sky Scanner. It's a Thopter. The battlefield to draw a card, okay. Lash Knife Barrier. I don't recall seeing this card on the list. When Lash Knife Barrier comes into play, draw a card. If a sorcery would deal damage to a creature you control, it deals how much damage? -1 to that creature instead. Okay. It's interesting. I've not heard of that one. Star of Extinction. It's a sorcery, a little expensive. It's a mythic card, though. Destroy target land. Okay. Star of Extinction deals 20 damage to each creature and each planeswalker. Oh. How kind. How kind. That's probably worth something. I've not seen that one before. And then Generated Horizons. Now that my kitty cat is gone, a little bit more room here to myself. Let's go to the next one. Okay, so let's see here. The Raven Standard Bearer, Human Soldier, Fragmentize, Wall of Frost. My husband likes walls. What do? Whenever Wall of Frost blocks a creature, that creature doesn't untap during its controller's next untap. Okay, that's cool. Augur Bolas to the battlefield. Genju of the Fens, an aura, Enchant Swamp. I've not heard of that card. There's a lot of cards that there's just so many that I just don't even know these cards. nature, barrage of boulders, or sorry, barrage, Volderen duelist, snapping sailback dinosaur flash, has dealt damage, put a plus one counter on it. Okay, that's a cool card. Hardy veteran, as long as it's your turn, okay. Urban evolution, it's a little pricey, but draw three cards, you may play an additional land. Mortar pod, okay. Living weapon, centaur, oh, that's cool. I don't know if that's worth anything, but it looks pretty cool. Chromatic Lantern, lands, okay, that's a good card. Control Wing Condition. This spell can't be countered to shroud. Okay, that's pretty fun. Alright, pretty good cards in there. I think I got some that we were looking for and some that we don't have, clearly. Alright, on to pack number three. So next we have Soul Summons. Ballynock Cohort. Youthful. Sorry, I'm out of frame a little. Youthful Scholar. Let's see. Temporal Fissure. Fetid. Imp. Recto Strike. Goblin Rough Rider, okay. Hulking Devil, so Blastoderm, Shroud, Fading Three, okay. Roots, enchant creature without flying, Mortify, destroy target creature or enchantment, okay, that's pretty good. Blighted Fen. Add one to your mana pool. Okay. Crater Gargadon. Suspend a 10. Okay. That's a lot of sacrificing. That's crazy. No way. I don't even know what to say. This is, for those of you who do not know magic, this is literally the most expensive card you can pull from this pack. Yeah, so we'll just cut the video here. Holy shit. Okay. That's amazing. Amazing. I mean, honestly, I dislike playing with this card. Yeah, she's there. That's crazy. Absolutely crazy. Okay. That's gonna go over here for now. Okay. There was three packs. My husband always lets me open these because I somehow have, like, I mean, I don't always pull good stuff, but I generally get very lucky. Very lucky with magic cards. And it's just so much fun. I'm like... like, no way. I can't believe it. I don't even want to open any more packs. Like, okay, all right, let's continue. Windborne. Oh, let me bring this closer for you. Windborne charge. Catarouche of solidarity. Laboratory maniac. Ooh. If you would draw a card while your library has no cards in it. Okay. That's a win condition card. That's what they call it, magic. And yeah, that would do it. Let's see. We also have Maximize Altitude. Okay. Jumpstart. Reaper of the Night. Oh, Dark Ritual. Look at that. I don't know how much this card is, but I know this is a very good card. It's a very good card. You pay one and you get three. So, it's like, buy one, get two free. Okay, that's a good card. It's a really sick art, too. I wonder if this one has more value than some of the other ones. Wall of Fire. So I know we just had like Wall of Snow or Ice. Wall of Ice. So now we have Fire as well. Insolent Neonate. Menace. Discard a card. Okay. Byway Courier. Investigate. I don't really play decks with Investigate. Let's see. Bitterblade Warrior. You may exert it. Tick attacks. Okay. I don't know what that is. Ooh. Sultai. I have not played this color. Sultai Charm. This is a value. I don't know how much it is, but these charm cards are usually really good. Really good to use. Ooh. Arcane Sanctum. So will I land? Release the Ants. What is this? Release the Ants deals one damage to target creature or player. Clash with an opponent. If you win, return. Release the Ants to its owner's hand. So, clash means each clashing player reveals the top card of his library, then puts that card on the top or bottom, and a player wins if his or her card had a higher converted mana cost. Okay, that's so weird, but cool. Deep Glow Skate. When it enters the battlefield, double the number of each kind of counter on any number. What is this? This guy's cool. Trial and error. I like this. That's cool. It's like a proliferate, but not, and honestly, even better. Okay. So, again, you know, no second mana crypt. Darn. But let's see what else we've got. I think. Oh my gosh, I still have so many. This is our halfway point. This one, right here. Oops. All right, perfect. Starting out with a Path to Exile. That's a staple card. Path to Exile. Shoulder to shoulder. Support too. That's okay. Cheering Homunculus. Homunculus. He's cute. Tandem Lookout. Okay. Reckless Spite. Destroy two target non-black creatures. You lose 5 life. Okay. Sure. Gifted Aether. Touch lifelink.
Frontline Rebel, Prickle Boar, Hamlet Captain. Ooh, who are you? When it attacks or blocks other humans you control, get +1/+1 until end of turn. Okay. Tribal deck.
Ooh.
I think I already pulled this one earlier. Or something similar. Ooh, Coiling Oracle. That's a good card. We've got that one. Ooh, Dismal Blackwater. A land. It enters stabbed. That's not like super great, but hey. Weathered Wayfarer. Whoa. Search a library for a land card. Put it into your hand, then shuffle your library. Play this ability only. It's got, you know, a stipulation there, but you can pull any land card, so if you have dual lands, that would be pretty good. Champion of the Parish. You manage the battlefield, put a +1 counter on Champion of the Parish. I can't remember if we already have this card, but, I mean, generally speaking, this is a good card. And then Recycle. Recyclabad. Recyclabad. Okay. Alright, so that's halfway through the packs that I have to open, so let's keep going. See what other goodies we find. Alright, starting off with an Abzan Falconer. He's a good guy. Angelic Gift. Okay. That's pretty good. Artificer's Assistant. It's cute art. Opportunity. Target player draws 4 cards. I mean, it's a little expensive, but if there's a way to get that out there without having to pay all 4, that's decent. Walk the Blank. Destroy target non-merfolk creature. Interesting. Grotesque Mutation. Yes, I would say so. Curse of Opulence. Ooh, wait. Isn't this a good one? Change to players attacked. Create a colorless artifact token named Gold. Yeah, he's a good card, actually. Skirk Prospector. Snake Umbra. What? Enchant creature. Enchanted creature gets +1/+1 and has whenever this creature deals combat damage to an opponent, you may draw a card. Ooh, and it has totem armor. That's pretty good. For a common, I feel like that's gotta have some value, but maybe not. Feral Krashok. Okay, he's an interesting looking creature. And then we have, Mercurial Geist. Flying when you cast an instant or sorcery. Okay. Renegade Map. Basically in card revealed, but in shuffle library. Okay. I mean, I feel like that's pretty good. Decent. It helps you find mana. You need mana to play the game. Mana Tithe? What? Counter target spell unless it's controller based. I've never heard of that. That's cool. I don't know if it's worth anything, but it looks really cool. It's a common, so generally those aren't super valuable, but I don't know. All is Dust. I have the All is Dust in Plains or White, and I believe it does the same thing but enchantments. I've not heard of this one. What is that? Also, like, is that God? What is coming? I don't know what the worth of these are, but these are so cool. I've not heard of those ones. Okay. Alright, moving on. I don't got all day. Alright, so Thraben Inspector. Pentarchal Avos Isle. Dream Cache. Let's see. Draw three cards and put two cards from your hand, both on top of your library or both on the bottom. Okay. That's not so bad. Farbog Revenant. Dirge of Dread. Is that how you say that? Dirge? Granitic Titan, Menace and Cycling, Rummaging, Goblin Rummaging, Goblin, let's see, Silhana Ledgewalker, Elf Rogue, it's got Hexproof, can't be blocked except by creatures with flying, okay, Fog, instant, but about all combat damage that would be dealt this turn, okay, Underworld Coinsmith. Whenever Underworld Coinsmith or another enchantment enters the battlefield under your control, you gain one life. You can pay one life and each opponent loses one life. Okay, I mean, that's interesting. Gateway Plaza. Gateway enters the battlefield. We have some other gates, but we haven't gotten enough yet to, like, make it into a deck or anything. Ooh, Sadistic Hypnotist. Sacrifice a creature. Target player discards two cards from his or her hand. So the only one. Only any time. Okay. Interesting. Trading Post. That's a card. Discard a card. You gain four life. Pay one life. Create a white coat creature token. Sacrifice a creature, return target artifact card from graveyard. Yeah, that's pretty good. Wizened Arbiter. Alright. I have a total of three left. Let's see what we got. Onuda War Cleric, okay. Tandem Tactics, up to two target creatures. Jeskai Sage, let's see. Aether Tradewinds, Bone Splinters, Pit Keeper, enters the battlefield. Have a former creature card to your graveyard, and you return target card from graveyard to your hand. Okay, cool. Molten Rain. Destroy target land. There's been so much land destruction in these cards. If that land was non-basic, it deals two damage to the land's controller. Interesting. Magma Spray. That's some cool art. Gaia's Cradle is what I'm thinking of in terms of a land, but like I would imagine that Gaia's Blessing is also a good card, because Gaia just seems like a cool person, you know? That's cool. Harrow. Just sacrifice land. Ooh. Rocks Warmonk. Lifelink. That's all he's got, but he looks cool. Bant. Is that Bant? I think that's Bant. Aether Spellbomb. Okay. That's cool looking. Crystal Shard, pay three, tap or pay an island, maybe. Return a target creature to its owner's hand unless the controller pays one. Okay, that's pretty cool. Boombile, flip a coin. If you win the flip, destroy all non-land permanents. What? What is that nonsense? No. Okay, so we're just gonna let fate decide on whether or not we're gonna board wipe. Okay, that's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. Alright. I feel like some of these have to be pretty valuable, so I'm excited to see what we get from that batch. but let's keep going. We've got two more to do. Mummy. Zombie jackal. That's pretty cool. Candlelight vigil. Predict. What is that? Choose a card name, then target player puts the top card of their library into their graveyard. If that card has the chosen name, you draw two cards, otherwise you draw a card. I guess, obviously, that could work if, like, you've scryed or did something so that you know what card is on top of your library. So, like, if you can easily play it that way, this would be a pretty valuable card, I would say. So that's cool. Retraction Helix. Until end of turn, target creature gains, return target non-land permanent to its owner's hand. Okay. That seems cool for a random something. Deadeye Tormentor. I avoid rats. Ooh, rats. Death touch. Okay. Built to smash. Fury charm. Okay. Centaur courser. Sentinel wood readers. Human druid. Enters a battlefield. Draw two cards. Okay, we got another charm. That's pretty good. Croesus's charm. That's a lot of S's. Croesus's charm. This one. Universal solvent. Pay 7. Destroy target permanent. Okay. Fiashano. Sand stalker. He's okay. Code. Listen. We were debating on, like, whether we should buy this box or not, because we just haven't had as much luck pulling magic cards lately, or I don't know, hasn't been any, I guess, good cards that we wanted to buy to do this. Anyways, long story short, I'm just, like, so happy that we bought these to do this. It's been so much fun, because we get the cool cards. Okay, sorry, I'm done nerding out. Anyways, a coat of arms. I know that was one that my husband really wanted. Each creature gets a +1/+1 for each other creature on the battlefield that shares at least one creature type with it. So, for example, if two goblin warriors and a goblin shaman are on the battlefield, each gets +2/+2. Oh my gosh. Yes. Yeah, the couple of charms that we got were really good too. We have one more. One more to do. One more. Then my box is empty. My box is empty. This is the last pack that we'll be opening tonight. I just want to say that I hope you've enjoyed this as much as I have. It's been a very fun and exciting time tonight. So I hope that you've been enjoying it as well. Alright, let's take a look at this final pack. We have Bonds of Faith, Youthful Knight, Cure Fedolkin, Fairy Mechanist. Okay. Read the Bones. Cool. rabid bloodsucker. Alright. I don't really play vampires. Dyna charge. Target creature you control gets +2/+0 until end of turn. Overload. Okay. What happens when you allow it? If you do change its stacked by replacing all instances of target with each. Okay. Cool. Act of treason. Fine. Nest invader. Roots. Okay. Soul manipulation. Prophetic prism. That is also a good card. Enters the battlefield, draw a card, and then you pay one, add one mana of any color to your mana pool. Yep, that's pretty good. That's a pretty good card. Dolmen Gate. Wait! No way. Prevent all combat damage that would be dealt to attacking creatures you control. For some reason, I think this one was pretty high on the list for value. So I think this is another really good card. Yeah. Kiki. I was just asking, we have him, I think, but in a different form of art. Put a token that's a copy of target non-legendary creature you control onto the battlefield. That token has haste. Sacrifice it. Yeah, that's a pretty good card. Experiment 5. Okay. Oh my gosh. This was so good. Thank you. Thank you for tuning in and for watching. I hope that you enjoyed it for either the magic cards or the ASMR or a mix of both. In either case, thank you so much for tuning in with me tonight. And I hope that you come back for another. Until then, have a